There's been a suggestion made by some this evening that somehow Republicans have restored education funding. The truth is that Governor Corbett proposed historic cuts in education, a total of $1.5 billion. This budget restores a fraction of that funding, but this budget still cuts $1.2 billion in education funding. In other words, this budget endorses 80% of Governor Corbett's education cuts. The education cuts in this budget are still devastating. In higher education, there are cuts of $250 million. In the education of our students from preschool to grade 12, there is nearly another billion in cuts spread across many line items. These cuts are devastating to schools across our state and to children at all grade levels. This budget raises many questions. What is the Republican plan for preschoolers? Well, this budget includes a cut to the state line item for pre-K and Head Start, and a 61% cut to the Accountability Block Grant line item, which funds preschool programs in many communities. What is the Republican plan for adult learners? This budget includes a 17% cut to literacy programs. What is the Republican plan for college prep students? This budget proposes total elimination of the dual enrollment program. The state will no longer help to pay for college prep students to have the opportunity to take college courses. What is the Republican plan for college students? Well, this budget includes a 10% cut to community colleges, an 18% cut to state system schools like Kutztown and Westchester, a 19% cut to state-related schools like Penn State and Pitt, and higher tuition bills across the state. What is the Republican plan for K-12 education? This budget includes devastating cuts district by district that will lead to program cuts, layoffs of school employees, higher property taxes, and reduced opportunities for our students. What is the Republican plan for the future of our state? That is a good question. A Republican named Abe Lincoln recognized the value of education. In fact, the land-grant university legislation passed during his presidency. A Pennsylvanian named Ben Franklin recognized the value of education. He said, "An investment in knowledge always pays the best interest." Today, there are some people in Harrisburg, there are some people in this House who want to retreat on our investments in education and who seem to have forgotten the value of learning. In the days to come, citizens of Pennsylvania will ask three questions. First, they will ask, why did this anti-learning governor propose such devastating cuts to education? On closer reflection, they will ask a second question. How did such a terrible budget pass? And in many parts of the state, citizens will ask a third question. Why did my local Republican legislator vote yes on a budget which devastates education, raises our property taxes, and slashes opportunities for our students? Mr. Speaker, I am against this budget. The cuts to education are too deep. These are the deepest education cuts in decades. That is not the kind of history we should be making. We should fund our schools. We should fund our future. We should not limit the opportunities for the young people of our state. I urge a no vote. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.